Easter's right around the corner, as you know, and we thought it would be a great thing to make a wonderful Easter ham, and then we're going to pair it with some biscuits so we can have biscuits and ham.
Okay.
And this is really easy. What you're going to need is one big old pork butt right here. There it is. It's a big old ham.
It's a ham bone.
It's a big ham bone, okay? And you can preheat your oven to 350 degrees, but what you want to do first is to take, you're going to take some of the fat off of it, and you're going to score it. Now, scoring it is very simple. I've already done some lines going this way, and then you want to, you know, you ever see those triangles on the on the hams?
Why do you do that?
Well, because you have to score it. It opens up the ham, and it looks pretty too.
Yeah, my grandpa used to put cloves in it.
Cloves, yes. And what I like to do with each little diamond, but it's not for this recipe, but you could if you wanted, between each little diamond, you add the little cloves. So see how it's coming into a little diamond shape right here. I don't know if you can see, if that reads on television, but you'll be able to see it when we take it out of the oven.
Intersection.
So there you go. Please bring in the ham.
It's the little intersection. Please,
yeah, the little intersection. There
we
go.
Ham?
All right.
Oh,
so this is what you do after you've scored it.
Oh my gosh.
And if you want to add the cloves in, please go ahead.
Oh,
wow.
Okay.
You're going to pour 3 cups of water to the bottom of the pan. The water dries out while you're baking it, don't worry, just add another cup of water to it. Now, we poured 3 cups of water in here. We're going to bake it in the oven.
Oh.
Again, it's at 350 degrees for 2 hours, okay? All right?
Are you okay?
Are you a happy boy?
Oh.
Do you need me to give you the Heimlich?
This
What's happening?
Is great.
Oh,
They're
my goodness.
Hamming it up now.
All right, now.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, my goodness. It's a big old heavy ham. Oh, man. Oh. Okay, now wait.
Look how gorgeous that is.
Look how beautiful
that is. Look like little pineapple chunks on top.
Well, that's a whole other different recipe.
I know, but it just looks like a little pineapple.
I know, but see, when you put the little cloves in there, too, it's really cute. Okay, now what you're going to do is make the rub, and it's easy. It's just Dijon mustard with some brown sugar, and you're going to make a paste.
Oh.
So you make the paste like that, okay, and then what you're going to do is you're going to rub it, which is my favorite part. I love rubbing things into food. Okay, here, I'm gonna do this. You just take it, just make a nice paste. And then, I love
this. You love rubbing things
into your food? I love it, look at this. Oh, look at this.
Is that what you said?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
That's fun.
You're excited she is right now.
I know,
it's just like, I love this stuff.
We're not even here. All that is brown sugar and mustard?
Yeah, mustard, yeah. And
I'm just
make
waiting
sure.
for somebody in a Belushi tone to yell, food fight.
Food fight.
Oh. From Animal House.
All right, so now take half of it, and just rub it all over. Make sure you just pack it all in there, nice. And so what this will do, it'll give it a real, it'll penetrate all the mustard and the sweetness from the sugar is going to penetrate this and make a beautiful golden color. Now, if you have time, I don't have time to make it look pretty because normally I like to make pretty food. Okay, so you talk amongst yourself for 1 second while I wash my hands. Okay, wait, 1 second, wait.
So, is that's gonna go back in the oven?
Yes.
So it goes back in.
That is gonna go back into the oven.
Okay.
And you're going to put that, you're going to do it for another hour, and you have to put your thermometer in there, and when it reads 145 degrees, it's ready. Now, be careful, because you don't want it, if it goes over that, you're going to dry out your ham, so make sure you stick a thermometer in there. So I'm going to, well, I don't have to, because, nope, it'll be here.
Wow.
I love that. That music follows me wherever I go.
Everywhere you go.
I know. So this is what I'm going to do.
Does that happen at the market when you're at the grocery store?
Yeah,
and
it does.
Off the shelf?
It does. So when you take this out after it's baked for an hour, what you do is you take the remainder of the mustard and the brown sugar, and then you put the breadcrumbs in it, and you put it back into the oven at 400 degrees for about 12 to 15 minutes. So you get this beautiful golden crust on it. So I just want to show you how...
Look at that.
Oh, my God. Look at this. Oh, beautiful.
So, Cristina, all in all, how long does it cook?
It'll cook about an hour and a half to 2 hours.
Okay.
You know,
and
maybe a little longer.
I have a question.
What?
Is there a specific way to carve a ham? Do you go against or with or?
You always, when you're cutting meat, you always go, and fish, it's always against the grain. So, if the grain is going this way, you want to do it this way.
Makes it much more tender, right?
Mm-hmm.
So
right. It does.
Yeah. Okay, so if I'm looking at that ham before you had cut it, how do you know which way the grain is going just by looking at it?
Well,
or do you make a cut and then you try to
Yeah, if you look at it like this way, Mm-hmm. You see how it's different than it is here. Right. It's all. You see that the grains are going this way, so you want to do it the opposite.
And then rotate. So it's maybe a trial and error, get lucky, 50 chance, right?
I'm a daughter of a butcher. My daddy taught me.
Really?
Yeah, my daddy was a meat cutter. And so he taught me the little tricks of the trade and how to cut this thing. But it always has to be against the grain. But doesn't this look beautiful? Where's that slice?
I could live off of ham and
biscuits
sandwiches.
Let's cut another slice.
I know.
Look at that.
So good.
Look how beautiful that is. And it's tender and it's joist. Just the way I like it.
And for a week after Easter, everybody's eating ham and
then you can make the best. You have to cook. You asked me the question about how long. It's 3.5 hours total.
Oh, gosh.
Total. Okay. Yeah, but you can make a great split pea soup, too.
Oh, yeah.
Is that based on the size, the 3.5, or doesn't matter?
It's based on the size, yes, absolutely.
Is there a difference between the whole ham and, like, when I go there, usually, I don't see these. I see the half ones, but you do the same recipe.
Right. I don't know where Haley found this whole
thing. That's
delicious. Now, you can add the Madeira to the pan that you cooked it in, because there's all the juice on the bottom. You add the Madeira wine to the bottom of the pan, and then you can, when you slice this up and you serve it on a serving tray like this, you pour the Madeira sauce over. It's delicious. Or you can just slice it. Let me talk with my mouth full. I'm so embarrassed.
Is this honey butter? What's wrong with the butter?
And then make
ridiculous
a sandwich. Look at these biscuits, how flaky. Wow. Everything is on our website. Look how beautiful that is.